Hello and welcome to a quick demonstration of SolidWorks. Today I will be using this miter saw to demonstrate how to create a new part, place it in an assembly, create a drawing. First place I would like to start is configurations. Configurations allow me to have different looks to the same assembly. What I'm using configurations for in this model are to show the different movements, so I can move the head up and down, slide it in and out using the different configurations. I'm also going to come in and start by deleting out this part. It's actually a subassembly. That quickly it's gone. Next, let's move this up and out of the way. I'm going to create a single part to replace that subassembly, and in order to do that I don't necessarily need the bottom portion of this, so I'm going to use a display state to hide everything. Great. Now that I have the model set up the way I need it, let's go on and create that new part. I'm going to start by picking on a plane, which is just like a piece of paper, and telling SolidWorks which type of entities I would like to use. As you notice, SolidWorks gives me feedback on the screen, what type of entity am I doing, and also if I'm going to create any sort of relationship. So let's just get this on the screen, and let's make this one. And you'll notice there that my size of the circles was not close, but it's fine. SolidWorks just gets the basic concept down, and then you can go in and correct it later. Let's add a little bit more geometry to make it a little bit more exciting. Instead of just having two cylinders, now we're going to have a rectangle with two holes. Great. Now that I have it, all I'm going to do is let's make the 3D, extrude it out into the 3D realm. You can see I have a little ruler trying to help me place it. And there you go. I have a feature in my feature manager and a sketch underlying it. I want to add more geometry, so I'm going to click on a face and just start drawing again. You'll notice again that I'm just quickly sketching stuff down, not too concerned about the size of things. And not that it's hard to use the Smart Dimension tool in order to come in and place the dimensions, but SolidWorks gives me a tool to fully define the sketch for me. Once that's done, I say OK, and there's my dimensions. As before, I just double click on a dimension, and I can fix it. SolidWorks adjusts automatically depending on how I needed it to work. Great. So I'm going to accept that sketch. Now with this one sketch, I'm going to get a couple of different features. I'm going to use the contour select tool, which allows me to pick certain regions of the drawing, of the sketch. I'm going to start with this one. Let's just extrude it back. Again, I'm going to use that ruler to help me figure out how far I am. Click. Let's go here. All right. We're going to click on this last one in here and create an extrusion. Pretty simple. Now, if I decided that I wanted this to be a hole instead of an extrusion, all I do is I click, pull through, and now I have a hole. I don't know too many softwares that can do that. I'm going to hide that sketch. Let's move on. Not that it's hard to create those features, but I want them on the other side. I could either recreate them manually, copy them over, but I like to use an even more simple method, which is to mirror. Just tell it what to mirror, about what. There we go. Pretty quick. Now, so that I don't want anybody to cut their hands, I'm going to put fillets on. So I'm just going to very quickly say that I want my fillets to be 20. Pick my parts. Say apply. I don't have to leave the command. I can keep going. Just do more fillets all at once. And I have a selection manager that is trying, SolidWorks trying to help me figure out what I want to do. You'll notice that SolidWorks does that a lot. It tries to help me, tries to make it very intuitive for me to get my design down. All right. With that done, let's say apply. And there we go. Very quick operation. If I want, I can come in and adjust the size of my fillet. But you'll notice that it's adjusting all. What if I just want the two interior corners here to be the different size? So I'm going to undo my changes. and I'm going to pick on the two faces that I actually have an interest in. Those two faces selected. Let's go back into the fill command. You'll notice I'm now on the change tab, and I can choose to resize. SolidWorks went in, did the work for me, and resized just those two faces, and even used its Swift technology to come in and reorder my feature manager in order to get it to model the proper way. I don't have to worry about playing the game of moving things around. SolidWorks will do it for me automatically. I also like to add a material, so I can right mouse click, say Edit Material. SolidWorks comes with a library. You can see it's a pretty extensive library. For this one, we're going to do 6061. Go on, say yes. Let's close this out. Now it has a material with all of its properties assigned to it. I'm going to save it first before I go any further. We'll just call it New Yoke. And let's bring it into my assembly. All right, so here's my assembly. I'm very simply to say, hey, let's bring in that part. I can bring it in close. It doesn't have to be perfect. And now I'm going to use mates as a way to tell it how these two pieces interact to each other. It's very quick. Has nice little symbols for me. And soon enough, I get my mates. Now I want to bring this head assembly back down, so I'm going to just bring that down in. There we go. Great. So it's looking good. Let's move this up and make sure everything stays in the same place. But if you notice close, looking closely, you'll notice that this is hanging out in no man's land. So let's change this part on the fly in the assembly. Just going to click on the part, say Edit Part, and this allows me to very quickly come in and grab this corner of this washer and say, you know what, I want to use that on my sketch. So I convert it over. Now I can start drawing some more information. There again, SolidWorks is trying to help me out. If I follow those yellow lines, it tells me the quadrant points, and it's telling me that I'll be tangent at that point. So SolidWorks is always trying to help you out. Looks like I missed something there. Let's delete that guy out. Do it again. All right, there we go. That's what I was looking for. All right. So let's create this little boss here. To extrude back 10, that'll be fine. All right. Now I have a little piece that it could actually go into, but it's missing the hole, so let's bring that in. SolidWorks has a command called the hole wizard, which allows me to come in, pick the type of hole, if I need a countbore, countersink, straight hole. I'm going to go for a threaded hole. Has multiple standards, multiple sizes. You just fill it out how you want it to look. Then you tell it where to put the hole. And there you go. Even has a nice cosmetic thread look to it because I have it being a threaded hole. All right. So now we've made some changes to our part inside of the assembly. Let's see how our assembly motion looks. If I move this down, everything looks good, but it looks like I might have some interference down in there. So let's check it out. I'm going to do something called a collision detection. Drag power only. So what I'm going to do is very simply drag this down. Yeah, I don't know if you saw it, it's pretty quick, but as I drag it down, this turns blue. The mating face on the yoke turns blue because I have it highlight faces. So basically what SolidWorks is telling me is that these two pieces hit each other throughout the prescribed motion. So I need to fix that. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to come in, pick the 60 millimeter depth, which is the depth of the first extrusion. Let's change that to 45. And when I rebuild this, you're going to see that everything updates. And this little tab right here stays in context with the washer because that is the way I defined it. Let's go back to the part, and everything shows up there as well. Okay. It's very nice, very easy. Next, I would like to put some dimensions on here so that I can bring it into the drawing. SolidWorks contains a tool called DimExpert. Allows you to place it down with your datums as if you were measuring it. So I'm just going to come in and very quickly select those faces for me. I'm going to let it do everything. SolidWorks thinks for a little bit and it turns the part green. Basically, the green means go. Everything is fully dimensioned. I can move dimensions around if I want. I don't like the way they're appearing. But more importantly, this 100th dimension. I do not like the way it's measuring from the outside of one face to the inside of the other. I would prefer to see a measurement from the inside to the inside. I can come in, delete this dimension. If I turn my preview back on, you'll notice I now have a yellow face. This is due to the fact that I have no information defining where that face is placed. So let's put that information back in. I'm going to click this face and this one. See an 8mm dimension show up. And just to double check that everything is good, there's my preview. So we're back to being fully defined. I don't necessarily want to see these dimensions while I'm in the model, so I'm just going to hide them. Once we've done this, let's make our drawing. So I'm just come in here. I'm going to grab the view I want to look at. Move it to that side. There we go. And that quickly, I have a drawing view. It's pretty quick. Brings in the dimensions that we had previously. Again, though, I can move them around if I need to. All right. It's just listing the hole twice. That's fine. We can delete out one of those, not harming anything by doing so. You can flip arrow directions if I come in here, click on this one. So you can clean up your drawing and have it be exactly what you need it to be to communicate your drawings. All right. Now these blue hatched lines are actually the tangent edges. If you do not like them, you can just remove them and it cleans up your drawing view. Let's say you want this one to actually look as if it does in real life. You can make it shade it. All right. So let's save this as an e-drawing. An e-drawing is a way to communicate your drawing to other people. You have the options of putting passwords on it, letting people measure or use sections. Let's go and open up e-drawings real quick. There we go. So this is a file that I can send to a customer. They can get a very good idea of what it looks like. They can click play. It'll walk through all of the drawing views. At any particular point I want, I can click stop. I can grab the rotate, move it around. You can use your mouse as well to zoom in and out, pan, and rotate. But I can always come in and say measure if I allow them to, and they can click on an edge and get a measurement. And you can always go back to home where you started from. This tool also has the markup capabilities where you can come in, click on something. And those comments will be passed back and forth. So if I come in and open a markup that I have saved that came with this drawing previously, there we go. You can see that other people's comments can come in as well, mainly that we need to watch the weight. All right, so let's go back to our model. Go to our assembly. Excellent. And actually, let's go into the part real quick, because I notice that my part up here doesn't have a fillet. So I'm just going to copy the fillet that currently exists onto that face, and we're good. All right. There we go. It's just recognizing that the part has changed and makes the changes for me. Now I'd like to do a simulation analysis on this. So I'm going to switch configurations to remove some of the excess information. And I can come in and start a new study. Alright. The contacts come in. The material comes in on all of them. So if I have a material assigned, it will come in. So all I have to do very quickly is add some how the part is held in place. SolidWorks gives you nice graphical information telling you what you're choosing. And I also need to apply some loads. All right. Alright, there's one. I also like to point out that SolidWorks is very customizable. That little bar that keeps popping up is called the shortcut bar, and you can customize it to be what you need it to be. If you never do this, then don't worry about it. I could type -750, but I prefer to say reverse. You can see how the arrows point in opposite directions. So that's going to simulate a load that goes on. Once that's done, all I have to do is right mouse click, say mesh and run. What SolidWorks does very quickly is break up the model into individual little components, analyzes them, and gives me an answer. So it's done meshing. Here goes solving the problem. You'll notice I have it turned on to always show the solver status. You don't have to do that if you don't want. But given what SolidWorks is doing, and the fact that I'm running on a fairly small system, it does it really fast. The answers are there. There you can see the stress, displacement, and strain. Now, specifically what I'm interested in is I'm interested in the factor of safety. So I'm going to try to create that plot for you. I am not interested in everything. I am just interested in the new yoke. I'll just leave it like that. We'll say OK. See what we can. Okay, so that is my answer. All right. If I'm looking for a factor of safety of 1, I am overdefined. You can see up here it says minimum factor of safety is 3.7. So what I can figure out from this is that I can go in and I can remove material from my part. So let's just go in and do that. Open up the part. And let's turn it around like this. Just personal preference there. Everybody has their little quirks. And I have a saw feature. Now the design library is inside of SolidWorks. And what this allows you to do is if you find yourself doing the same hole pattern, the same cut, the same feature over and over and over again, instead of recreating it each time, save it down to your design library. And that allows you to very quickly drag it out onto your screen, place it on the part. SolidWorks gives me feedback again. It's asking for that blue circular edge. So you pick the edge on the part, and it'll place the feature as you need it. There we go. Very nice. Shows up in my feature manager right there as a design library. You see this is a cut, a fillet, plane, another rib, and another fillet. So it's multiple features inside of it. Now, not that it's hard at all to drag it out onto my screen, but I'd like to get this on the other side. Now, if I take my design rollback bar here, roll back in time, see how my part was made. You can see here we go. I'm just going back in time, watching how the part was made. All right, kind of steps through. So if I could get this cut to be before the mirror, which I'm going to just drag and drop, Now it shows up before and it comes in. Pretty neat. Now the last thing I might want to do is I have a part on my computer already that I know has this cut pocket that I'm interested in. I can search for the part, find the feature, and drag the feature out onto my part. I don't have to save it as a design library feature. I can just go and get it and pull it out. Now the placement isn't exactly right, so I'm just going to come in and very quickly fix that out for myself. So let's make those concentric. This 26, hey, let's make that 30. There you go. Last but not least, let's put some fillets in there. Let's make these small. I'm going to use my selection manager again to help me pick which one is the correct one. That looks good. The only problem is I don't really want it on this circle or this one back here, so I just click on them and deselect it. And you can see with those few clicks, I got 70 edges. So I'm going to say OK. Now we have a new part here. Let's go back to our assembly. The model updates. I could go back into my study at that point. You can see I have a mesh problem as well as results. I just need to remesh and run. I don't need to set up the study again, and I can get the results again. Let's just say that we're satisfied with what the results are on this one. By the way, if you don't want to see those symbols, you can come in and hide those symbols. All right, very easy to get rid of them. Let's go back to our drawing because we've just had a lot of information to our part. Let's make sure our assembly is fine. So our drawing updates, but I'd like to add in more details. So let's do that. Let's go with the detail circle. I really love the SolidWorks detail circle. You'll see why. SolidWorks gives me flexibility to come in and be very sloppy in my placement, because I can come in and fix the location later on. All right. I picked up a relationship that I didn't intend to. That's not a big deal. Let's just fix that real quick. Yeah, let's get rid of that one. All right. All right, so here we go. Now that's more like it. It's always good to see me do a little snafu every once in a while, right? So now that I have my detail view the way I like it, I can move this down, clean it up a little bit, but it doesn't need much cleaning. There we go. How about let's also do a section view? I'm gonna do a partial section cut. I'm going to flip that up. SolidWorks also gives me the ability to come in and say, you know what, let's ignore those rib features right there. Come out, place the drawing. And there it is. Now, I've already placed the dimensions before, so I need to actually add in some more dimensions. I can just click on here. And SolidWorks adds the dimensions that I need for these particular views. This dimension here looks a little crazy, so I'm going to just move it down to another view to where it makes more sense. So just because a dimension comes in on a particular view does not mean that it is stuck being on that view. All right, pretty happy with this. Got to move this down a little bit. So there's minor cleaning up of the drawing. And I could create an e-drawing again at this point and send this out and somebody else will have a good idea. Let's go into the assembly though. And let's go back into the full assembly. So SolidWorks is going to think for a little bit about this. Switch to all parts. Because now you'd like to see an assembly drawing view. So let's just move this head up. grab it like that. All right, so let's create an assembly drawing. Same as before, just create an assembly, make it. And this time I'm going to say, 1, 2, 3 views. All right. There you go. It's pretty quick to get those drawing views on there. All right. What about coming in and having this be an exploded view? So let's do that. Let's make this one shaded so you can see everything. Now, some things are kind of hidden. SolidWorks gives me the opportunity to come in, change the orientation in order to make it better. Don't like that one, you can always go back to the other one too. There we go. All right. There we go. Nice. There it is. Sometimes you just have to wake them up. Well, let's put some annotation, some balloons on here. So I'm just going to come in and very quickly say auto balloon. SolidWorks will come in. I could do it individually, one at a time. But I'm just going to come in and do it this way. You do square or circle. Doesn't really matter. You can also add a bomb. So let's do top level only. If you don't want to use the standard ones, you can always come in and create your own. So let me see if I have one that I might like. Let's use this one. There it is right there. Move this drawing view over a little bit just because it's getting a little bit crowded up there. But you can see you can have descriptions and items and motions on specific configurations. Let's put those auto balloons on again. There we go. It was a little busy the last time, so that's kind of why I went back and redid it again. So it's reading the bill of materials. Once you get them placed in, okay, you just say, all right, you can come in after that and individually move a particular balloon around to get it in a location you find more satisfactory. All right, there you go. Can't really see that one. But you'll notice these numbers correlate with the number in the bill of material. And that is how you do an assembly drawing. Thank you for your time. I hope you found it informative. Have a good day.